the Champions League final coming up in a little more than 24 hours. There's been a lot of discussion about how these venues for the Champions League final are chosen. You've spoken about putting them out to tender.
Mm-hmm.
You've started doing that, which wasn't done before. Can you talk a little bit about the advantages and disadvantages of doing that and what it means?
First of all, Kiev was appointed as a host for the Champions League finals one day after my elections. It was the only proposal, so we could just choose the one was the only candidate. Later we changed the procedure. We have a strict bidding procedure, we have conditions, and about pluses and minuses of that, it's they are all pluses of clear tender procedure. The only minus is that it takes one political tool from the president.
So in other words, you can't reward, in inverted commas,
exactly.
Countries.
Exactly. I can't do it. We have an evaluation report from our administration about every single point of the bid, and then executive committee votes.
Is there a risk then that, you know, certain bigger, better connected cities, it will always be the same 10 or 12 cities?
Look, for me, Champions League finals, and not just for me, objectively, it's the biggest single sports event in the world. So it has to be in the places that are capable of hosting it. If it goes more than once in one of the big cities, or more than twice or three times, it's still okay, because it has to be top of the top. It has to be user-friendly, let's say, fan-friendly. It has to be big enough that the prices don't go sky high, as it happened not this year only, but last year and years before. So I think top of the top competition should be organized only in venues that are capable of organizing everything, not just the match.